Christmas time is my favorite time of the year because I love the food, I love the decorations, I love the music, but there is one thing that drives me nuts. The cheesy Hallmark Christmas movies. You see, because we're bombarded by what feels like thousands upon thousands of these hokey movies every Christmas season. And I think the reason why these specific movies drive me nuts is because of the shallow depictions of love. You see, love is the second theme that we're focusing on as a church this Advent season. This word love in our English vocabulary today has been reduced to a shallow, sentimental feeling. But in the Word of God, in the life of Jesus, we see the depths of the word love. Agape is a benevolent love. It is goodwill, and agape love involves faithfulness and commitment. And as we recognize love this second week, we see that God is the very nature and essence of love. He is love itself. God's love was most displayed to us in his son Jesus. In 1 John 4:10, it tells us, "In this is love, not that we have loved God, but that he loved us and sent his son to be the propitiation for our sins." Because of our sin, we were incapable of being in fellowship with God, but Jesus. Because of our sin, we were deserving of hell, but Jesus. We saw the love of God on display as Jesus came into this earth as a baby that would live a perfect and sinless life. Jesus willingly came into the world knowing all the bad that he was going to experience. Jesus knew that he would be despised. Jesus knew that he would be rejected. Jesus knew that he would suffer a painful and humiliating death on the cross. But because he is God incarnate, he was raised from the dead on the third day. And because of love, if we recognize that Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life, we have access to God and all of his benefits. This is love. It isn't shallow. Instead, it is deep and it flows alongside grace and mercy. Love is shown through Jesus as the just died for the unjust. And that's why we celebrate Christmas. This is how the theme of love can be seen in John 3:16 and 17, which reads, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only son that whoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life. For God did not send his son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him." So as we prepare for Christ's coming birth, let us still have fun with our different Christmas festivities, but let us remember always the importance and hope of his love.